My name is Sahil Ahmed. I work as a data scientist at Blue Sky Analytics. We are a geospatial data intelligence startup, primarily focused on creating environmental data sets for better monitoring and climate risk assessment for various stakeholders across the globe. We are aiming to build Bloomberg for environmental data to drive sustainable decision-making and safeguard the global market from climate change-induced threats. Having said that, I would shed some light on one of the critical issues we are facing, air pollution. Air pollution is a serious health issue. WHO reports around 7 million premature deaths every year, majority of which is caused by outdoor pollution. The air quality data itself shows clear indication that climate change can directly increase the risk of exposure to air pollution. Greenhouse gas emissions from burning of fossil fuels are some of the key drivers that are the cause of this air pollution. Despite this grave situation, the need of the hour is active monitoring. We believe what you can't measure, you can't solve. India currently have a network of around 250 air quality sensors, which by no means is capable of monitoring air quality on a country of this size. Ground sensors are expensive. They have a limited coverage. There is also a case of finding the right location so that sensor could be maximum utilized. At that point, we realized that the ground network can be complemented with another layer with a higher spatial resolution, more coverage, and cost way less than a normal EQ sensor. Smart EQ uses machine learning, combines data from near real-time observations from satellite as well as ground monitors to create a continuous spatial temporal map of PM2.5 at 1 kilometer resolution on a daily basis. In order to do that, you not only need bulk of data, but also the right kind of data. DRISO sources its data from multiple sources like NASA, ESA, ECMWF, through an automated data aggregation and processing platform called Geospatial Refinery. The dataset ingests AOD observation from MODIS and Sentinel-5P. This is a key attribute that tells the presence of aerosols in the atmosphere. From smoke coming from car or chimneys or dust, they all comprise of aerosols. A value of 0.1 represents clear sky, while anything beyond 1 represents hazy. Air quality also depends on weather data sets. For example, a higher temperature might dissipate all those aerosols. A heavy rainfall also clears the sky, while a low temperature in winters could assemble all these particles within the city, creates low visibility and smog. We source these weather data sets from ECMWF. In order to calibrate the satellite observation, we also gather some data from AeroNet network. These are the network that provides AOD values at different wavelengths, helps us calibrate the satellite observation. And last but not the least, the hourly PM2.5 data that we get from 250-300 ground stations that not only helps in calibrating, but also validating our model predictions. Findings from our model shows that it does a significantly good job in predicting PM2.5 daily, monthly, and annual concentration at an unprecedented spatial resolution. A sample base cross-validation shows a stable accuracy of R2 score of around 0.85 and an error metric of 15 microgram. Now, these are general scores that are done over a period of time and across multiple regions. In general, SmartEQ model is robust and can accurately estimate PM2.5 concentration by taking account of all these meteorological and aerosol particles. It could be used in several applications like research studies, near real-time tracking, and other use cases of air quality management. This is the portal looks like, where it shows the data sets. This map is a 24-hour average value that we generally generate on a daily basis. Our data set was used by international energy agencies in their recent annual publication in order to demonstrate number of clean air days in any year. Processing large number of files on your system could prove inefficient and maybe time consuming. In order to save the hassle, we created Geospatial Data Refinery, a cloud-based platform capable of streaming terabytes of data into gigabytes of insightful information. The aim of creating this refinery is to provide a solid backend capable of harvesting, processing, and analyzing, and then delivering through APIs and dashboard. This is how the tech stack looks. The application layer is held by Node.js. Most of the raw data is stored in S3. All those expensive queries that we make spatially or temporally is cached in Elastic Cache. Most of the processing is done on AWS Lambda. It's a serverless architecture. And then Timescale and PostGIS for querying these data sets. Thanks, everyone.